Earlier this week, we told you the story of Christian Smalls, the Amazon worker at a warehouse in Staten Island who was fired after organizing a walkout on Monday. Now, according to Amazon, this worker was fired because he organized this walkout, or because he was instrumental in the organizing of a union that's still trying to take place there. No. It's because Christian Smalls allegedly had just constantly violated the company's policies about social distancing and, you know, other health protocols they've put in place because of coronavirus. And that's why we had to let Mr. Smalls go. He was breaking the rules left and right because apparently he had come in contact with a worker who ended up testing positive for coronavirus. But while this worker was awaiting their test results, they were still coming into work every day at the Amazon warehouse. Which, by the way, is kind of a violation of the federal protocols, right, Amazon? You should know that. If you're going to accuse people of breaking the rules, you kind of got to start with yourself on that one, because if you're awaiting test results for coronavirus, you were supposed to be in quarantine. And yet you still let him come to work knowing that he may have it. So automatically, off the top, your talking points, your excuses, total crap. Total crap. And furthermore, we know that you're also full of crap because Vice.com reported on Thursday that they had obtained a copy of a leaked memo from an Amazon executives meeting before Smalls was ever even fired. And this memo details the ways in which Amazon wanted to try to discredit Mr. Smalls. Here is what they said in this email, and this is from Amazon General Counsel David Zapolsky, had this written down in his notes. He's not smart or articulate, and to the extent the press wants to focus on us versus him, we will be in a much stronger PR position than simply explaining for the umpteenth time how we're trying to protect workers. We should spend the first part of our response strongly laying out the case for why the organizer's conduct was immoral, unacceptable, and arguably illegal in detail, and only then follow with our usual talking points about worker safety. Make him the most interesting part of the story, and if possible, make him the face of the entire union organizing movement. Now, actually, I do believe this happened after Smalls had been fired. It's not really clear on the date of it. So maybe it was before, maybe it was after, but either way, the story's been told now, Amazon. You can't lie your way out of this. We have the memo. We have your quotes. You wanted to paint this guy as a liar, as an idiot, because you said he's not smart, he's not articulate. But you were the ones who screwed up. And what's interesting to me, as I mentioned, we did this story earlier in the week. And the day after I did it, I got an email. Got an email from a PR person. Now, her email is not from Amazon.com. It's from confidant.co. And she says, "Hi, Farron. I'm reaching out for a few corrections on your recent story on an Amazon employee who was recently fired." She used recently twice, or recent twice, in the same sentence. That takes skill. Good PR. Amazon only fired one employee. Only 15 people walked out on Monday, and employees were not fired for walking out. Also, here are two statements from Amazon to help clarify. So this PR strategist, as her email address seems to say, again, it does not come from Amazon.com. There is a phone number there, and it's got some statements from Amazon folks. Here's one. I'll just read this. This is from Avzamat. An Amazon spokesperson says, "These accusations are simply unfounded. Of the more than 5,000 employees at our Staten Island site, 15 people, less than 0.5% of associates, participated in the demonstration. Our employees are heroes fighting for their communities and helping people get critical items they need in the crisis." Yeah, your employees are heroes. And nobody's trying to demonize them. Except, of course, you, because again, we have the memos. You're the bad guys in this, Amazon. And you can spin it all you want. You can brag in your meetings about your PR machine, but we now know the truth. You are attacking workers because they want to protect themselves, they want to protect each other, and they want better conditions. And what you are doing right now is beyond reprehensible and absolutely disgusting.